Hello.
Hi, welcome back in the kitchen. And Neil Salters is with me.
And I have to relearn all my chords. I'll probably say this again later when people join in, but after watching Callum, I have to go back and relearn all the songs.
Many, many of you were with us last week when I was in Callum McCall's kitchen, and we just had a lovely time. Callum, Kerry, and myself, and Kenzo, their dog.
Yeah, and some great songs.
And we had some, and what, do you play different chords completely from Callum?
No, he's just better.
Callum will be feeling very good about that. He is some guitar player.
He's great. Although I was a little disappointed he didn't play the dog song.
Do you know, I asked him to play the dog song. He's fed up playing that dog song. But he played some new songs that were just so good. Welcome, everybody. I don't know where you are. We have people tuning in from Tasmania. Yeah. Fiona in Tasmania.
That's great.
And never mind that, Fiona. There are Fionas everywhere, including the sheep called Fiona. I mean,
there's a sheep watch.
The sheep called Fiona. I'm called after Princess Fiona in Shrek. Did you know that?
No.
The sheep that got lost and had been there for 2 years by itself is called Fiona because, I don't know, there was a sheep in Australia or somewhere or in America called Shrek that got lost. So they thought, this is a partner for Shrek. Fiona's famous now.
Finally.
That 50s and 60s name. Nobody calls their child Fiona anymore. Do you know any one-year-old Fionas?
No, but I did teach a Fiona.
Oh, did you?
Yeah. She's doing dentistry now.
So she's an old Fiona?
No, she's not. No, she's just off to uni, I mean.
Phyllis, hello. Sheena Reed, hello. Phyllis is always lovely. And Phyllis tunes in every week. But then so does nearly everybody already. You're all tuning in. And Jean Thompson is watching. That's really nice to know. Jean, it's freezing in Aberdeenshire. It's wet. Frank, a very good evening to everyone. And to you, Frank. And Margaret Tyndall, hello. And Kenny Lindsay, hi from Sunny Fife. Well, you're lucky. I don't know what it's like. Hello from Nairn, says Agnes. Tina Faulkner-Elder says hello. And she's in Inverbervie. Susanna Pearman-Bradley's in Sydney, Australia. So that beats Inverbervie. And Hazel and Betty and Berton, and you're all coming in so quickly that I am not managing to catch up. Kathleen Fettes, yes, hello. And Floris Calderwood, lovely to have you. Jean Thompson.
We have the same time zone in Inverbervie.
Jean Caron is watching.
We have the same time zone in Inverbervie as Tasmania.
Moira MacArthur, hello. And Susanna Pearman Bradley, I love you too. Sheena Reed. And a rainy night. It's raining. It hasn't stopped raining all day.
Yeah,
and it's cold
bad.
And dreary. The golfer is here.
Back.
He's back. He's got his crossword puzzle. He's been banned from any clue right now. He's got that look in his face. And I don't like it. Niels knows already. We're not letting him speak. And I should say thank you so much for all the wedding anniversary.
Yeah.
Greetings and congratulations and all that. 39. Mm-hmm. Niels.
Did you write a song?
No.
No.
Surprisingly, no.
Do you know? But he was very, very good on the present front, I have to say.
Yeah. Bunch of flowers.
Very nice books, a bunch of flowers. Or is it still Holland flowers?
Flowers.
Well, we sing
Tulips.
A song. Tulips. Today is Hug a Musician Day.
It is.
And today is a Kindness Day.
Yes.
Which also fits in. So if you know a musician, hug him, her. I'm sure everyone who watches is kind anyway.
Yeah, it should be Kindness Day every day.
Exactly.
Because there's something going on in Braemar. It's also someone I should know is Hannaford, like Tina will tell us in the chat.
Okay. It's freezing in Braemar.
I can tell you.
It's freezing in Braemar Day. Now we're going to sing a song that I'm just going to go over to the kitchen table and get. You could start the introduction. Nice, because it dates back a bit. I have to say may well be simple, but they're true. Until you give your love, there's nothing more that we can do. Love is the love is what we came here for. No one could offer you more. Do you know what I mean? Have your eyes really seen? You say it's very hard to leave behind the life we knew. But there's no other way. Now it's really up to you. Love is the key we must learn. Truth is the flame we must burn. Freedom, the lesson we must learn. Do you know what I mean? Have your eyes really seen? The words I have to say may well be simple, but they're true. Until you give your love, there's nothing more than we can do. Love is the opening door. Love is what we came here for. No one could offer you more. Do you know what I mean? Have your eyes really seen? Do you know what I mean? Have your eyes really seen? The words I have to say may well be simple, but they're true.
Lovely.
Oh, the golfer said that was lovely. Is it? I thought it's a really mellow way to start the concert, but this was released in 1971 by a lovely singer called Leslie Duncan.
I'd never heard it before.
And she just had a very rather deep and more growly voice, but really telling. And there's a gentleman in the Abergeldy Bar in Aberdeen who has requested this a number of times, and I was waiting for Niels to come in because I knew that he would like it. So
there we go.
There we go. And Linda Patterson, she thought it was a lovely song, and so did Kay. They both.
Yeah, it's a great song. We need to find another singer to do the
to sing that song.
The third harmony.
Oh.
No, not.
Yeah, it was not a really lovely song.
Pretty nice song. We need a new singer. And a new guitar player.
You know what? Someone who will remain nameless once said to me, I promise you this, she came to a concert and said, Fiona, that was such a lovely concert. I must buy one of your lovely CDs. You just put them on and you turn them right down. They're lovely background music. Oh, boy. Now, I was told by Kerry, Calvin's wife, that I should ask everyone watching to share right now. That I'm not telling people to share.
Share the video.
And today is National Kindness, International Kindness Day, and Hug a Musician Day. So we need to share that, and we need to do that before Neil sings one of his songs, so that more people can hear your songs.
Or not.
I mean, Susie Bogus, you were over in Nashville, Tennessee.
Yeah, that was fun too.
And you did a lovely concert in her kitchen or her sitting room.
Yeah, with Doug at the wheel.
Doug at the wheel. See, the golfer could be helping us.
Well.
Instead of snoozing in his...
Does the crossword question. So.
Niggers.
I'm not even...
Niggers, N-E-G-U-S.
It's fine.
It's not a bad word, I promise you.
I'm not even repeating that. It sounds like a bodily part. I am not going to...
It's a word, N-E-G-U-S.
Okay, I'm speaking over him right now because he's in that kind of a...
Somebody will have heard.
N-E-G-U-S.
Okay, I'm hoping no one. I have no idea. Niels, what are you going to say? Share
we're gonna
quickly.
Do,
just all you have to do is press share. Apparently.
What will I do first?
We've already done.
Let's do How the World Has Changed.
Okay.
I haven't done it in a while. I did this with Susie as well. And...
You wrote it when?
During COVID. Because we thought at the time, how much has the world changed and how much has it stayed the same? And it's
Guess
still
what?
True, so...
Nothing's changed.
Nothing's changed.
If anything, it's got worse, but we're not... We're here to cheer you up.
Yeah.
Aren't
so
we?
You can sing along probably by
you
now.
Can't. There's harmonies. You could fill in the third harmony, because Neil's is looking for another better singer.
No, just another singer. What is it George always says? That's one of the shows I've ever seen. That's one of the songs I've ever heard. Okay, here we go. Oh, something's still the same. Oh my, how the world has changed. Oh, something's still the same. Oh my, how the world has changed. Oh my, how the world has changed. Nice to meet you, I won't shake your hand, we can fist bump, we'll let our elbows do their thing. I would have hugged you, but I don't know where you stand. We could laugh it off, or we could bring it in. Oh, something's still the same, but oh my, how the world has changed. Oh, something's still the same. Oh my, how the world has changed. Oh my, how the world has changed. Used to be if you robbed a bank, you'd hang a poster saying, wanted men. Now you're an outlaw if you try to buck the trend. I've got friends on both sides of the fence. Oh, something still the same, but oh my, how the world has changed. Oh, something's still the same, but oh my, how the world has changed. Oh my, how the world has changed. Tanks are rolling across the border, chaos arising out of order. People dying, the scenes are dire. Stay on the sidelines, don't fuel the fire. Oh, something's still the same. Oh my, how the world has changed. Oh, something's
My grandma's 100 years old. I lost my mama some years ago. She said, all that remains is just our souls. Grandma says we'll meet up further down the road. Oh, something's still the same. Oh, my, how the world has changed. Oh, something's still the same. Oh, my, how the world has changed. Oh, my, how the world has changed. Oh, my, how the world. Oh my, how the world has changed.
Good song.
Good harmony, thank you.
Oh, the golfer's woken up. That's good.
So there you go.
I'm glad that you like the harmony. Susie Bogus, if you were here, you could sing the third harmony.
Yeah, and Doug could have done the fourth one.
We could have been barbershop.
We could, yeah.
I mean, in fact, we could have been like Granite City Chorus. Had many harmonies.
Let's make it happen.
I mean, where is John Conroy?
Yeah.
Because exactly. They know how to do harmonies, those
they
boys.
They really do. They really do.
It is a really good song, the news. You recorded it in Nashville recently.
Oh, yeah, and it's going to go on Verlin's album.
Is it?
Yeah, which he's still...
Hot news!
So the album in Kincardine, and I think you got a song in there too.
Oh, boy, he's not looking for another singer.
No. I think...
Verlin Thompson, who may well be watching, because Verlin, although he lives in Nashville...
He's in Nashville, but you two did My Heart Is There With You.
Yeah, that's a beautiful song too.
And I think that's going on the album, but I think he's just wrapping up a few last bits and pieces before the album comes out.
We'll keep
that song is going to be on that too.
Good. So. Well, we'll keep you posted. It's really nice to hear about albums actually happening. Never mind that. When is your album?
Well...
Mr. Procrastinator.
I recorded 7 songs in Nashville, which is a great start for not recording anything for a long time.
He writes all these songs and everybody loves them. It's just a question of, the good thing is that these days you could put an EP out first. Callum McCall made an album after all these years and the superb musician, and he called it About Time.
Yeah, and it's a great album.
It is a great album. Look up Callum's. And then what are you going to call yours? Mr. Procrastinator.
Told you I was busy. No, I'm actually really excited about it because it's taken this long to get it recorded. And, you know, with your help and everybody's help getting out to the studio, it was just a little push that I needed to get it done.
It's great.
And it's actually, having your own studio, you don't tend to record your own stuff. So, but going into another studio and having somebody else push the buttons.
Yeah.
It was really nice.
And you're happy with the songs,
Happy with the songs, which I wasn't expecting. And then, of course, Verlin is playing some great, great guitar parts and some harmony parts on there. So I couldn't be happier with the whole thing. So even if only you, me, and Verlin listen back to it, I'm happy that it's been
You'll love it. You'll love it when you hear it. I know. We'll say hello to a few people. There's Kathleen is watching and she's in Ireland. Hello, very warm welcome to Kathleen Duffy. And Elizabeth Lissamore McGilvery is watching, and I know she's down south a bit but comes up to Scotland a lot. I also want to say a couple of hellos to there was Fiona in Tasmania, who's originally from South Uist, I think. I'm going to go and get... I've left things on the kitchen table. Bear with me.
Don't go anywhere. Yeah.
You know, I was hearing quite a lot on the radio about Joni Mitchell. Is it 50 years or something? Like? like
yeah.
that. I mean, I love Joni Mitchell. I love
Me too.
Everything about yeah. her. And I just loved how she is matured gracefully and yeah. her voice has matured with her
yeah.
in that wonderful way. And she's such an artist in every yeah. in every sense of the word.
There's a guy who has a YouTube channel called Rick Beato, and he does some really good interviews with people. And his channel's gotten pretty big, and he says that the last big ones that he's trying to, the people he's trying to get, but they're hard to get hold of, is Joni Mitchell, and he's also trying to get Paul McCartney and Ringo, because, you know.
Well, they're going to be harder to get now that they're number one.
Yes.
I mean, that's yeah. fantastic.
Did you see the video for it, too?
I did.
I thought it was very good.
Yeah, really, really great.
Anyway, so, yes, there's some people that are absolutely, they have a good track record for songs and...
Well, it's just lovely that they're all still working.
And they're still going.
And that's inspirational. It's like yep. Callum's mother, Peggy Seeger, legend.
Yeah.
And Peggy is still working, yep. which is yep. great. I mean...
Yeah. I think if you... I mean, why wouldn't you be?
Well, exactly.
If you like it.
You're going to have to knock me out with a hammer.
Yeah.
If that's... So this is for tribute to Joni Mitchell. Yesterday, a child came out to wander, caught a dragonfly inside a jar, fearful when the sky was full of thunder, and tearful at the falling of a star. And the seasons, they go round and round, and the painted ponies go up and down. We're captive on the carousel of time. We can't return, we can only look behind from where we came, and go round and round and round in the circle game. Then the child moved 10 times round the seasons, skated over 10 clear frozen streams. Words like, when you're older, must appease him, and promises of someday make his dreams. And the seasons, they go round and round, and the painted ponies go up and down. We're captive on the carousel of time. We can't return, we can only look behind from where we came, and go round and round and round in the circle again. They go round and round, and the painted ponies go up and down. We're captive on the carousel of time. We can't return, we can only look behind from where we came and go round and round and round in the circle game. So years spin by now, the boy is 20. Though his dreams have lost some grandeur coming true, there'll be new dreams, maybe better dreams, and plenty before the last revolving year is through. And the seasons, they go round and round, the painted ponies go up and down. We're captive on the carousel of time. We can't return, we can only look behind from where we came and go round and round and round in a circle game. And go round and round and round in the circle game. Oh, it's such a good song.
It's a great song.
I mean, and it does make you think as well.
Yeah.
Callum and I were talking last week about words and I mean, how his parents, both Ewan McCall and Peggy Seeger, in terms of masters of words and the economy of words and telling your story economically, but totally cutting through and actually having that broad appeal. The songs like that that have international appeal, it doesn't matter. I mean, when people say to me, oh, I only like this music, well, I mean, good music is just good music.
Good music is good music.
Country,
the end.
Rock, classical,
I get that people are into different styles of music in terms of, I run into people sometimes who don't really listen to the words of songs.
No.
And that's okay, but that's surprising to me. So we're doing really well. We're very entertaining.
That's how good we are.
Lullabies. Anyway, people can listen to whatever they want.
You see, these songs are so good, they put people to sleep.
Yeah, relaxing. But anyway, so, but I'm a big fan of songs with either a story to tell or, like you say, where they're so economical with their words.
But that's what you do so well, too.
I do like that. It's and that was so nice about going to Nashville too, because, you know, people really, as I imagine that you and McCall did as well.
Ooh. Oh, that woke the golfer up. do you know, it doesn't matter if that we're doing a concert or
I'm Houston.
Oh, well, she wants a clue, I bet you. Your sister sent me something today that the word for the day is Hercule Dercule. It is a 200-year-old Scottish term. What does it mean? Hercule Dercule. I'm not even paying any attention to him. Don't even listen to him, Neil.
Anyway, I was going to say that you and McCall, obviously very good with as a wordsmith, and it's the same in Nashville, that they really like, they work on every word and every line, and they really try and get every... squeeze every bit of juice out of every word.
And it shows. Yep. Beth Nielsen Chapman is just also another crafts person that we can only aspire. Marcus Hullin
and
Verlin Thompson.
You need to look him up and you need to meet him. Don Henry.
I've heard of Don Henry.
Is fantastic. He is so good as well.
You and Lydia, and he wrote a song.
We wrote a song together. He's only Grammy Award winning Don Henry.
I mean, I've heard of him. I can only kind of go...
But he's great as well. So look up Don Henry music. Don Henry music. But anyway, he's another great one.
I'm going to, so the Hercule Dercule, you can look that up. Tina Faulkner Elders, I can't believe the copper is historic. You better believe it. It's because we're a bit mellow.
We are. It's cozy here.
The fire's the fire. On. It's actually really nice. I wanted to flag up something, and maybe Steve Baxter, wonderful graphic designer Steve Baxter, could maybe put up a link. If you're in the Aberdeen or Aberdeenshire area, we're doing a concert aptly called Windswept, which was Sophie's title for it.
Great.
And Colin Hunter, who is a lovely singer himself, is putting a fundraising concert together at which Paul Anderson is taking part, Colin Brockie, Moira Doherty, Aberdeen University Choir with Sample, Neil Burse, there's more, and yours truly, not you on this one, but it's a musical journey.
It's hard for me to be windswept these days.
It's a musical journey around Scotland,
great.
And it's a fundraiser for St. Margaret's Braemar, so... Steve, I know you're just great at doing all the tech stuff, so if you didn't mind putting up a link, because you can get your tickets now. And if you haven't shared this already, please do share. You just press share, don't you? Is that?
I think
You're a bit more of an expert. I've only done 120 programs, and I still don't understand.
Find somebody next to you who knows how to do it. That's what I do.
Are you going to sing us a song?
I could do another one if I can reach the notes. It's high, but... Okay, I recorded this.
And what is it?
And it's called Grandad's War, and it was Remembrance Day the other day, so...
Well, yes, yesterday, and...
Yeah.
I was in Peterhead. I would just like to say thank you to everyone who was in the Remembrance Day march, and there were the Sea Cadets looking fantastic, and pipe band, and it was wonderful. Bob Fraser and all the team that put that together, and it was a very moving ceremony.
And so when my granddad was alive, when you're young, you don't know what questions you should be asking. Right, and after they're gone, you probably think, I wish I'd asked, blah, blah, blah. Anyway, I did ask him at some point about the war, you know, with big parts of the Netherlands being occupied at the time. So he did have a few stories about it. And one of these stories really stuck with me, which was that at some point, the German troops would take all the crops and load them onto cargo trains and then run them back out to Germany to feed the troops out there. So particularly in winter, then there wasn't anything to eat. So as young lads, they would, under the cover of night, run alongside these cargo trains and then climb on and then stuff their pockets with whatever they could, onions, potatoes, and there'd be like salt, you know, heaps of salt that would be frozen because it was winter, and they would use like their heels to hack at the salt and then stuff their pockets with it, and then they would jump back and then have something to eat, which is, you know, inconceivable in some way, at least to us. But
and your grandpa inspired this song is inspired
so
by
this song is really about that image of these boys running along the train and jumping on and trying to stuff their pockets. But more so, it's just a song about, you know, as the last living survivors of World War II are leaving us, we're all in danger of losing the lessons that people learned from World War II, which is clearly evident with the state of the world today. So the other reason for writing the song is to try and capture something of a message not to be forgotten, which is Remembrance Day.
And the title of your song?
It's called Grandad's War. Here we go.
My granddad lived through the war, when the lowlands were occupied, death went door to door. He lost friends and found ones he didn't have before. He said, we don't carry the weight, just the sorrow. And we don't carry the hate into tomorrow. Cargo trains, famine days, young boys run, sneaking on. Grab my hand, fingers frozen to the bone. Use the heel of your boot, hack that mountain of salt. Stuff your pockets, jump off and run back home. My granddad's appetite for life, and my grandmother's still stoic years after he died. And the stories to remember, 'cause we try, and we don't carry the weight, just the sorrow. And we don't carry the hate into tomorrow. Cargo trains, airplanes, young men run before their guns. Grab my hand, fingers frozen to the bone. Tell my sweetheart I tried to live a long and thoughtful life. Take this locket to her and run back home. My granddad lived through the war, when the lowlands were occupied and death went door to door. We have dear friends in Germany we didn't have before. We say we don't carry the weight, just the sorrow. And we don't carry the hate into tomorrow.
Something like that.
That was lovely.
So, that's
that is a powerful song.
My granddad.
Oh.
All those stories.
But that's what it's about, telling telling the story and telling out beautifully, beautifully constructed.
Thank you.
Magnus.
Oh.
And the word?
We're not even paying attention to him. Don't speak. I'm going to tell you about the Hercule Dirkel. Did anyone know? Amazing, said Amanda. And Annie Warren, amazing and beautiful song and singing it so lovely.
You.
And Tina loved it. And Anne Houston, great, Niels. And Rhoda McDonald, beautiful song, Niels.
Thank you.
That's lovely.
Yeah.
It's
emotional. Song.
It is emotional, but I think people just relate to your grandpa lived. Did he not to
97. Yeah.
And, you know, living through the warriors, and your grandma?
She's 104 now.
104. Amazing.
I know. In the other song, I still say that she's 100, but because it's too hard to say she's 104. It doesn't fit in the lyrics. So she'll stay 100 forever in the other song. But
104.
104. And...
good genes.
Yeah, so
pretty good. Yeah. Amazing.
Yeah.
Okay, lots of people are saying that they really love that.
Thank
and you. Doug Clark is watching. Welcome, Doug. And I wanted to say hi to Fiona Faulkner in Tasmania, because she is from Polacher in South Uist, where the golfer and I stayed a couple of years ago. And she'll be listening from Tasmania. And we used to listen to your dad as wee kids. I mean, other than New Zealand, Tasmania is still a long way. Yeah. Tasmania is a long way away.
Yeah.
I tell you...
She likes backwaters.
Who... I think you should stay asleep. He's not well behaved. He is not in a well behaved mood today. I had a very good friend and wonderful writer from Tasmania, Barrington Thelong, who sadly died in, he was just like 60, and Barrington wrote all the music for Inspector Morse. Mm. He wrote Truly, Madly, Deeply, and I was very lucky that he wrote the music for three Scottish poems that's on the Made in Heaven album, mm. and he just wrote music that seemed like it had been there forever, and he was a real character. Anyway, Fiona in Tasmania, and to Fionas everywhere, including Princess Fiona. Oh, that whole sheep story really took the world, didn't it? I mean, I think we do need these stories now and again that actually just cheer us up a bit.
We really do. There's a lot of there's a lot of trouble in the world, so we need some good stories.
We do need, and music. We have to keep doing the music. The golfer keeps trying to interrupt me, and I keep ignoring him, because the word for the day, hurkle-durkle, a 200-year-old Scottish term, meaning, does anyone know?
Thank you.
Beautiful, Neil. Someone is writing in. Yes, lovely song.
Can I answer?
Perhaps fit it into the song 100 plus 4.
Wow. 100 plus 4. That's how I'll do it.
Thank you for that suggestion. You see, people are listening.
Our
kitchen concert viewers, they're not just making scrambled egg in the background on toast. They're with us in this kitchen.
Well, I can say it's something you do, darling.
There's an answer.
A lie in bed.
Yes.
You're quite right. A hurkle-durkle means to lounge in bed long after it's time to get up. So happiness is a hurkle-durkle.
Oh, I'm going to have to use that.
And your sister sent that to me today. Hurkle-durkle.
That's good.
That is good. A lie in bed. Heather Barry, lovely song.
Thank you.
So, actually, we're going to try singing a song that you and I wrote. And mm-hmm. When Niels and Tina had their son, first of all, they had Anea.
Mm-hmm.
How old's Anea now?
14.
Boy.
Oh, no, which means that
boy.
The song we wrote.
Boy Blue, which we're just going to sing just now, which Niels and I wrote very soon after
Luca
was born. And is he 10?
He's 11 now.
11? How could that be?
I know.
Could you tell them to lie about their age, like we do? Now that you're 17 and I'm 37.
They're going to get to the point where they want to lie about their age, but the other way.
I know. I always wanted to do that too. I always wanted to be the lady going to the cocktail party. Suddenly, in the plastic high-heeled shoes with glitter. Oh, for a pair of high heels.
Yeah.
If only high heels were comfortable. I mean, that's the other thing, since we all lounge around in our house. No more high heels. So this is a song called Boy Blue.
Yes.
And it was totally came about because when Luca was born, it was just such a magical time. And it was just having a boy, wasn't it? Having a baby boy.
Baby boy.
And that was quite special. So will we give it a go? We haven't done it for very long.
Do you know that you did a show, I think in the Cowdery Hall, not long after we wrote that song, and I think that was with James Muldoon and George was in it.
John Bett,
and you performed that one, and it had, again, really nice, like, three-part harmonies, I think, in it.
He's looking for another singer again.
It was just really nice because I was in the audience and I wasn't expecting you guys to.
Well, you weren't in it.
No, I wasn't in it.
Oh, it must have been The Kissed then.
Yeah, it probably was The Kissed.
Oh,
yeah. So that was a really nice treat to kind of hear the song.
Yes. Yeah, I never thought about it like that.
Yeah. So,
anyway. So now we need another singer.
And another guitar player. Like Callum. If you missed the beginning, I said I had to relearn all the songs after listening to Callum play.
Callum McCall. All the songs.
Callum McCall plays all the songs better. So.
We're going to get Callum up here to write some songs with us. That's the aim.
Yeah.
I'm chivying him. They say it's some journey. You're still young. Deep breath before you go. Be good with your name. Head towards the sun. Whoever knows, whoever knows. They say that you're leaving now and that you're going with the wind. Well, she knows the way your young heart blows. So listen when she sings. A life on open wings. Boy blue. Said it's very good.
Bad practice, good performance.
Yeah. I think that's true, actually.
Yeah.
But we said very good considering how bad it was when you tried it earlier.
We just tried it five minutes ago.
We just tried it just before, and Something.
We almost got there.
Yeah. Suddenly it comes together because you're with us.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know if you know how important you are out there, but even although we're just a phone, a ring light, a snoring golfer who are ignoring his clues, but it does make a difference. And everybody is saying lovely, a great concert, and thank you both for all the songs and the lovely guitar playing.
Very welcome.
So you see, I think you're doing yourself down here. I think Callum and you and I need to go on the road.
We do. That would be fun.
Wouldn't it be fun? I think...
We'd probably not do an awful lot of singing and playing, but it would be fun.
Give me some warning so I can plan something as well.
Okay. What would you plan?
I'd plan a golf trip.
Yeah. Or you plan a golf trip.
Well, I'm not going.
Yeah, but you can't sing the third harmony anyway, so that's okay.
Yeah.
Are we going to do one for the ditch, as they say? What
could do.
What would we do for the ditch, as they say? We're nearly... do we need to do... is there something? We didn't practice anything, but that's not an unusual situation.
No. Do the kiss.
Would the kiss be nice?
Yeah.
Now, that would be... Well, let's see if we can remember that. Given that we're doing sort of singer-songwriter songs...
Yeah. Is that the right thing?
Is that around A something like that?
Tools of the okay. We'll find out.
This song came about because, well, you mentioned The Kist and Boy Blue was in The Kist and John Bett directed The Kist, and we did it at the Edinburgh Festival and we did it in New York and Glasgow and everything. And... this song came about because I went to an exhibition at the National Museums of Scotland where they had piles and piles of Kist, an old Scots word for a trunk. And in the 1800s, in the olden days, the tradition was that you put special things in your Kist, usually for a wedding day or a special occasion. So it would be something that would be for the bridal trousseau.
Yeah.
Does anyone even use that word anymore?
Trousseau. I do all the time.
And it had such a vivid and effect on me. And I went to New York to Ellis Island, and the exhibition had gone there, and they piled all these Kists up, and it was just staggering to see the different shape, well, all about the same shape, but different battered ones and sort of wicker ones and wooden ones and ones that were posh with initials. And people took them across oceans, never knowing if they were going to return home to their country. And that's how the Kist song came about.
Yeah.
And Beth Nielsen Chapman and I wrote it together.
Let's get this right.
Excuse me. White lace, a lock and blue, the family Bible, precious papers, tools of the trade, a christening robe and a prayer for our survival, tucked inside the Kist as the waves crash round, sailing on the ships for the new world bound. They sailed to Ellis Island, Nova Scotia steeped in brine, sailed the endless ocean to stand there in a line, searching for their fortune, dreaming of a day and a new life far away. Lock and booth, the family Bible, precious papers, tools of the trade,
christening robe and a prayer for our survival. Tucked inside the kist as the waves crash round, sailing on the ship to the new world bound. They helped to form the country, entwined and trusted ways. Some were the founding fathers, became the fabric of the place. And in a quiet way they toiled, their families think the same, and the values hold today. White lace, love, precious papers, tools of the trade, christening robe and a prayer for our survival. Tucked inside the kist as the waves crash round, sailing on the ships for the new world bound. They were tucked inside the kist as the waves crashed round, sailing on the ships for the new world bound.
Do you know, given that we have not sung that in several years and we didn't even rehearse it.
I know, I suggested it and then I got a little worried as we went through it and I thought, I don't really know what comes next.
Muscle memory.
Muscle memory kicks in.
Actually, that is amazing. We missed out the middle eight, but that doesn't matter.
That's for the next one.
Thank you for joining us. Neil Saunders, everyone.
Thank you.
Thanks for coming
Thank
in.
Thank you for joining us.
And we'll see you next Monday. Bye for now.